quiet in a minute. Hey, come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise. Something about that name.
Amen.
Whatever you need, call on that name, Jesus.
Amen.
You can't sleep.
Hallelujah.
Say Jesus.
Jesus.
Somebody get in your face. Invade your space.
Amen.
Say Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Come on.
Lord,
I already said this. Come on.
Lord.
Amen. Amen. It feels good just to be here and worship the Lord. Amen. Amen. You start your week out right. Amen. In the Lord. Amen. So it's a good thing to be here on today. Just to give God some praise. One of the reasons why we come is to give God the sacrifice. Do you know that worship is a sacrifice? But it is a commandment, amen. And that's why we bring the sacrifice of praise. Come on, these are old time songs that we're singing. Come on, help us out as we sing. We bring the sacrifice of praise into the house of the Lord. We bring the sacrifice of praise.
Push past your flesh.
Amen.
is a commandment. Let's give the Lord a hand of praise. God commands us to praise Him. Amen. And sometimes it's good to shout to the Lord. Amen. It's good to shout. Sometimes it's good to shout to the Lord. God is the one that invented passion. God is the one that invented passion. You think He don't want it? He wants us to be passionate. He said, the word of the Lord says, it's the fervent, effectual prayer of the believer that availeth much. God wants passion. He wants you to put your heart into it, amen?
Amen.
Yeah, there we go. That's right. He wants you to shout to the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Our Jesus and our Savior. There's none like Him. No, you can look all over the world. Nobody will love you like God. So that's why we worship Him.
Thank you.
year that we walk in our promised land. Amen. We all been given a promised land because we are all heirs to the blessing of Abraham. Amen. And in order to know what promise God has for you, you got to go read the blessing of Abraham and watch how God blessed Abraham. And we are heirs to the blessing. But in order to receive the blessing, you got to know that you're an heir. When you find out you're an heir, don't you go after your inheritance?
Yes. Yes.
Don't right. you knock people out the way to get to yours, right?
Right.
Well, we are heirs to the blessing of Abraham, but we have not because we asked not. Amen. That's called the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for recognizing that. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord another hand. Amen. Worshiping God is a beautiful thing because God loves it when we worship Him. Amen. There's a blessing attached to that. You cannot worship God and walk out the same. You can't be glad and mad at the same time. If you want to get rid of anger, start praising God. Amen. That's praising God brings joy. Praising God brings joy. All of us just need the joy of the Lord. Amen. The joy of the Lord. The joy about darkness. Amen. The joy of the Lord will drive out all anger. Amen. Can't be glad and mad. As soon as you get glad, mad gotta go. Mad gotta go. I said just like that. Mad gotta go. But you gotta let God order your steps. You gotta let God order your steps. Amen. Amen. He said, let everything that hath breath
praise the Lord.
That's not a suggestion. That's a commandment. He said, let everything that hath breath praise you. If you breathe, He's talking to you. He's talking to you. And He's talking to me. To order our steps. We speak that name, Jesus, right now. The name of the Lord. We speak the name of the living God. That name is Jesus. That name is Jesus.
Jesus.
Gifts only come from God. But you know, ministry is where you work out your gift. Amen. So this is a ministry. We're not all perfect here. We be singing songs. Some of us don't be on the right note, but ooh, when we come together, is we come together to praise God. Amen. Yolanda Adams. I love Yolanda Adams. And, you know, but we can't get Yolanda Adams to come. So I remember when we was out on the sidewalk, a lot of people, they said, they thought I was Yolanda Adams. And I didn't say nothing otherwise. I didn't lie. I just didn't say no. Amen. But God got, you know, God got, he got a lot. He's got a lot. I was trained. We were trained. I came through the Foursquare organization. I won't call it religion. The Foursquare stands for the full gospel of Jesus Christ. If Jesus taught it, they believe it. That's why they're called Foursquare. And the Foursquare began as a, it's really mission orientated. And a lot of, they would send 30 teams all over the world. And all you had to do to be on one of those teams was to raise your hand. You raise your hand and say you wanted to go. And when you raise your hand and say you wanted to go, all they did was train you, prepared you, and then they send you. They send you on out. But one of the things that they taught us is to bring up the leaders right in the community where you're ministering. It doesn't make sense to get people come from the west side, because they gonna come once and they may not come again. But they taught us to raise up the leaders right here in the community. And I'm so honored to be able to look at a lot. These are all leaders right here. These are all leaders right here. They're all leaders. These are all leaders, people that have decided to serve God. And faithfully, we have an elder. Elder Campbell is right here. But that's the one thing that I love about this ministry is it allows whatever the gifts are that God has given you that he wants to use. We got a young man that's been faithful to this ministry. Amen. Brother Dave, he's been filming us. He, Brother Dave was with us when we was out on the sidewalk. He got great footage. His footage ain't no joke. If you want to see the footage that he does, that he does, he tapes the Sunday morning worship. He's on YouTube, Dave Martin. Look him up and subscribe to him. And you'll be able to see that he's doing some professional footage. Amen. And there's more gifts that are in the house on tonight that come regularly. Let's show some love for Sister Lillian. Amen. Amen. Today is her birthday. So we're going to sing happy birthday to Sister Lillian.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Lillian. Happy birthday to you.
Wait a minute.
How old are you? How old are you?
Love my pastors, And I love all the homeless because I come from drug addict, alcoholic family in Chicago. I came here to break the chains and I did break them. But that's why I'm telling you, all of you, we all servant of the Lord. And we all the same. There is no colors, no, not because you're black and you're white. Da, 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 da. No, God sees us all the same. May God bless you all. Amen.
Amen. She just told me tonight, because we would have the cake and the balloons and everything. So we're going to celebrate it on Friday night. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And it was someone else I wanted to give an acknowledgement to. Let's show some love for our dear brother right here, Brother Jermaine. Amen. Faithful. And he brings his whole family. This is his family right here. His wife, his daughter, and all of these kids are his great. He brings it. Let's show some love for Brother Banjo right there. He don't have it, but that's a mighty man of God too. Amen. Where's Brother Rocco at? Is he outside? Okay, well, we don't count. Okay. I'm not gonna be before you long. I'm not long-winded at all. Amen. But the Lord did put it on my heart that we need to start teaching His word. Amen. And the gift, I'm not a preacher. I have never, in 16 years, I've never preached in my ministry. Amen? Because I'm not a preacher. But God had to remind me that He's given me the gift of teaching His word. And the one thing that God has put on my heart is to speak about tonight is the Ten Commandments.
Pardon? Not
right now. We've got to wait. Amen. God said let everything be done decent and in order. And so I'm not going to be long, so that's why I want to go and just do what God is telling me to do right now. And I want to talk about the Ten Commandments. Who can give me all ten?
I
need all ten. Who can give me all ten of the commandments?
I don't want to.
You don't have all ten. Okay. That's the problem today. We don't even remember the Ten Commandments. That's our problem today. We don't know the Ten Commandments. There's Brother Rocco. Let's show some love for Brother Rocco. Mighty man of God. Amen. Mighty servant. To be a mighty man of God, that means you're a mighty servant. Amen. And we're here to serve God. The Ten Commandments, I'm going to read them. We seem to have forgotten about the Ten Commandments. But, you know, we're not only under the Ten. Do you know we're under every commandment that God has given us? When He said, greet each day with praise and thanksgiving in your heart, that's a commandment. The reason it's a commandment, because He didn't say, try to do it. He didn't say, think about doing it. He didn't say, if you can fit it in your day, do it. He said, greet each day with praise and thanksgiving in your heart. And do you know when you obey what God tells you to do, do you know there's a benefit attached to every commandment of God? I'm going to give you an example. They could have, I'm sorry, I got to do it like this. There's a lot of noise. You guys, I'm at that age where I lose my train of thought. I'm getting ready to say it in a way that everybody can understand it. So forgive me if I say it a little blunt. They can have AIDS on every corner. If you're following God's laws, it ain't going to touch you. They can have it on every corner. Everybody down here could have it. But if you're following the laws of God, do you know it's not going to come near your dwelling?
Yes.
It only comes near your dwelling when you're not doing it God's way and you're doing it your way. The smartest thing that I learned how to do was when I realized, I said, I can't do this myself. I finally realized that I was making mistakes with my life. Every time I looked up, I was making mistakes. And I finally realized that I didn't know the way to go. And I needed God. I needed to learn God's way. Do you know when I stopped doing it my way, I stopped making a lot of mistakes with my life? Yeah. I was making mistakes every day. I was up today, down tomorrow. I was taking one step forward and 10 steps back. And then when I thought I had it together, I started learning His word and walking in His word. I started obeying His word. Do you know I slipped up one time, and that was the greatest mistake I ever made? I said, damn, I've been doing it right so long, I just made one mistake. Okay, let me tell you what I learned about that. When you're trying to do it right, the devil is just waiting on that one mistake. He waiting on that one mistake. When you're trying to do God's will and obey His word, the devil is laying in wait. That's where that term came from. He waiting on you to make that one mistake. And then the Bible says He comes in like a flood. He looking to see who He can sip like wheat. Amen. All it takes is one mistake. So let's go over the Ten Commandments, because the reason why it's so important, I tell people, we've got so much lawlessness going on right now. Racism is back, rearing its ugly head. I'm trying to listen. I'm listening to God. Amen. One of the things that there's so much lawlessness that we've gotten away from the law. And the reason why God gave Moses the law to bring to the people, because there was so much lawlessness going on. So He said, well, let me give them 10. But the reason why those 10 are important right now, because we need to, if you're doing anything, make sure you're not violating one of what I call one of the original commandments. Stay away from that violation. Stay away from those. And we're going to read them so that you'll know, at least you'll know what to stay clear of as we're on our walk to learning how to obey God's word, how to love one another, how to forgive one another, how to be a tither, how to be a giver. All of those are commandments. But how can you walk like that if you don't know how to walk according to the law and not violate the laws? Because I call them cardinal rules. There's some sins, there's some things that you do that God is not playing with you. He's not playing with you. Not everybody down here on Skid Row, you're here because of sin. Some of you are here because you're running from God. And in order to go up, He got to bring you down. In order to get you to climb, He got to bring you down. You was too high. You thought it was your job, your money, your wife, your kids, your car, your suit. God said, I can take all that away, and then it's going to only be me. You here now? You where He wants you now. So you got nowhere to go but up. You got nowhere to go but up. So you might as well go on, climb that mountain. He ain't gonna move it though. But He will give you the strength to climb. Amen. I'm just gonna go over the 10, and I'll elaborate at another time. But let's make sure we're clear of these 10. Get this part straight with God. Get it straight, because these are what I call cardinal. It's the cardinal rule. Okay, here we go. The Ten Commandments. Nobody in here could give me all 10. So if you can't give me all 10, that means you don't know all 10. So you don't know, you could be violating one or two here and there. Amen? We want to make sure we ain't violating these rules. Number one, thou shalt not have no other gods before me. He's a jealous God. But it's a good kind of jealousy. It's that kind of jealousy where you don't want nobody fooling around with your wife. Wife, you don't want nobody messing with your husband. It's a good kind of jealousy. Amen? God don't want nobody before Him, because He's the only God. He's the triune God, but He's the only God. Everybody else is God, little g. Little g. Number two, you shall not make no idols. We shouldn't have idols in our life. I can't go to church because I got to watch McGuire. I can't go to church right now because I got the Dodgers are playing today. I gotta go see the Dodgers. Idols, whatever that thing is keeping you from God, it's called an idol. If it's keeping you from going to church, if it's keeping you from praying, if it's keeping you from getting in the Word and studying the Word, it's called an idol. Number three, you shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. God is holy. You shouldn't be putting God with nothing other than, I love you. Hallelujah. Don't put it with nothing else. Don't put it with nothing else. Treat it whole. Treat it like it's holy, because it is. Number four says, keep the Sabbath day holy. You guys know I say this all the time. It said, keep the Sabbath day. Let me tell you what it doesn't say. It doesn't say, try to. It doesn't say, if you can. It said, keep the Sabbath day holy. We call Sunday the Sabbath day. There are some religions that call Saturday the Sabbath day. Notice it didn't say what day. So don't argue with nobody about what day it is. It just says, keep the Sabbath day holy. That means no, whatever that day is no cussing. You can't cuss people out on the Sabbath day. If you mean Monday through Saturday, you should be nice on Sunday. Do something nice. Don't be mean on the Sabbath day. Amen. It's the Sabbath day is a good day to forgive somebody that you might have an unforgiveness. That's a whole thing. Forgiveness is holy. It's walking in the light. The other one says number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're up to 5. Okay, number 5 says, honor your father and your mother. It says honor them. It didn't say you have to agree with them. It didn't even say you had to like them. We all go through that little teenager where we just can't stand our parents. He didn't say nothing about that, but he did say honor them. He did say honor. I know some people that are no longer here because if you read it in the scripture, it says, so that your days can be long here on this earth. I know some people that didn't honor their parents, and they're not here anymore. And they left this earth early. They left early. So don't play with that one. Honor your mother and father. He didn't say you had to agree with him. He didn't say that they was going to be right. They could be wrong. I know people say, well, my mother gave me up when I was a child. Still, and then you meet them. Honor them. Amen. Number 6 says, you shall not murder. It says it like this. Thou shall not kill. Thou shall not kill. Please don't do that one. That's a spirit. That's a murder spirit that makes you want to kill somebody. So if you feel like that towards anybody, that's the time to drop on your knees and pray and ask God to remove that spirit. And if you got to lay hands on yourself, you do what you got to do to get rid of that spirit. Because I know people in prison for the rest of their life. And it ain't that nice. You don't want to go and find out that it's not nice. And while you free, stay free. Here's another one. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Adultery is when you're messing with somebody that's married to somebody. It didn't say nothing about them having to be with that person. I know somebody that's been separated for 20 years. 20 years. I wouldn't touch them with a 10-foot pole. As long as they're married, I ain't touching them. Because that one brings a curse. That one brings a curse. You don't want a curse on you. Thou shalt not steal.
Oh, man.
Not steal.
We're not supposed to steal, y'all. We're not supposed to steal. I had a problem with stealing when I was a kid. I'm going to be honest. I'm going to set somebody free. I had a problem with, I thought I was helping my mom with 5 kids. I figured if I just get somebody's money, take somebody's money, I was helping. That's how the devil told me. The devil was a liar. Oh, he a liar. The devil told me, said, well, you can go and take that money, because you take that money, you're helping your mom out, and you need to help your mom. I couldn't work. I was too young. But I'm so glad that God took that away from me. I wanted to get rid of it. I wanted to get rid of it. Anything you got in your life that is in here, all you got to do is want to get rid of it, and God will help you. God will help you. The other one says, you shall not bear false witnesses against your neighbor. That one means we can't be lying on each other. That's in the original Ten Commandments. We shouldn't be lying on each other. They said, somebody came to me today at church, and they said, well, you know, Kanye West, no, it wasn't Kanye. He said, wait a minute. He said, well, you know, P. Diddy, you know he gay, and him and T.D. Jakes, right? I looked at him, I said, no, I don't know that. And because I don't know that, I'm not saying that. Because I don't know, until T.D. Jakes and P. Diddy say it out of their own mouth, I'm not repeating that, because that could be a lie.
Yeah.
And they just trying to sell newspapers, and they just trying to make money in the news. They trying to sell gossip magazines. They say all kind of stuff. But if you don't know it to be true, this is in the original 10, not to lie on one another. And now we get down to the last one that says, you shall not covet. Thou shalt not covet. Covet means to take something that belongs to someone else. It's kind of like stealing, but you're not taking it, but you're coveting. You're claiming something that belongs to someone else. How many of you know that God, everybody in here came with a gift? So we don't need to be angry or mad or want somebody else's gift, because if you get with God, he's going to show you, you got a gift too. You got one too. A mighty gift. If it come from God, it's a mighty gift. If you use it, it's going to do a mighty work. Amen. So these are the 10 commandments. We got to go back to the 10 right now, because there's so much lawlessness in the world. And it's not just people on Skid Row. It's not. There's lawlessness in the government, in Beverly Hills. It's not just here. But this is a place where you get an opportunity to get to know God, to walk a closer walk with God, walk in his miracle power, because God will take everybody in here to the palace. He has taken people in the Bible from prison to the palace.
Okay.
So you can go to the palace if you want to go. Everybody in here said, well, I need housing. Somebody need to be asking God for a house. God can take you from Skid Row to owning your own home.
Yeah.
Owning your own home. The Bible said he's part of the promises, houses and land. We're supposed to have houses, not one. Not one. So one of the ways that we start walking in our promise with God is we got to start being obedient to God's word. Amen.
Amen.
That's the beginning of it. And I spoke about coming out of the darkness into the light. We got to come out of darkness into God's light. Amen.
Amen.
I said I wasn't going to be before you long, but I just wanted to share the 10 commandments. And just, I don't want nobody in here violating the 10. Let's at least get that part straight so that God can start blessing us. Amen. Because God ain't going to, the old folks used to say, God don't bless men. He ain't going to bless men. And I hear people say this all the time. Well, God knows my heart. And what's your point? Yeah, he created your heart. But he wants you. Not that he knows you. He wants you to come and get to know him.
Yes.
To know what causes the blessings. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
So God bless your heart. I just wanted to just, God just told me to just go over the 10 commandments. And I just wanted to just do that. Amen. To be obedient to that. But one of the reasons for this ministry is so that we can extend the hand of Christ. We're going to go on and close the service, but we never close the service. We're going on 16 years. We've never come one time without extending the hand of Christ, giving an opportunity. We've lost a lot of people. We've lost ministers in this ministry. We've lost people that have come and was faithful, and then we hear that they're gone. But do you will never understand the joy in our hearts to know that that brother or that sister is before the Lord when they left. You'll never know the joy of knowing that we know that he or she went to heaven when they left this earth. You got to make sure that you're heaven bound. You got to make sure, because you got to do it now while you're able to make that choice and make that decision. Because faith is right now. You can't, don't do it like this. Don't say, well, I'll do it later. I'll wait till later. I don't want to do it right now. Because guess who heard you say you're going to wait till later? The devil. And that later will never come. We had a guy that when we was on the sidewalk, he loved the ministry. And he said he had just gotten out of prison. I don't know if he got out or not, but he came to our ministry. He loved it. And he said, I love this. He said, I want to come back. And he promised to come back. And he didn't come back. About 3 weeks later, the guy that brought him, I said, whatever happened to that young man that said he really loved the ministry? He got into it with a friend. The guy that he got into a fight with, he knocked him out or something. They got him for assault, and then the guy died. Now he was in for murder. All he said was, I'm coming back. He didn't make that commitment. He just said, I'm coming back. So if you commit, because you've heard the word of the Lord, the devil's going to try and snatch that word from you. Oh, yeah. Somebody sitting here right now have made a decision that they're going to walk with God now. Yeah. Somebody sitting under the sound of my voice has said, I'm going to get this out of my life. I'm going to start walking with the Lord. So if that's you and you want to walk with God, you got to say yes to Jesus. You got to give your heart to Christ. He's the sacrificial lamb. Back in the day, in order to come to God, they had to slay. They had to slay a calf or something. A lamb, a pure. It had to be a pure lamb. That's how they came to God. That was the only way they could come to God. Well, how many of you know Christ became our sacrificial lamb? And a lot has changed. We don't have to slay a lamb to come to God. All we have to do is say Jesus. Amen. So if anybody is under the sound of my voice, and if you've been encouraged on tonight to give your heart to God, and if you walked away from God, and if you've been encouraged to come back to God, this is the altar call. And this is the call where if you want to come back to God or just give your heart to God, we do ask you to come forward. We ask you to come forward. Don't be scared. Don't be ashamed. And we salute you. And we're here for you. Is there anyone that would like to come to the Lord on tonight? Praise the name of the Lord. Is there one? I always believe that there's one. Is there one? Hallelujah. Come on, let's give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord another hand praise. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. The word of God does not return void. Is there someone else that want to say yes to Christ on tonight? Don't be afraid and don't be ashamed. If you're a little shy about coming forward, if you just want to stand on your feet, stand up for Christ, because he died on the cross for us. Hallelujah. God bless your heart. God bless you. Amen. Is there someone else, someone that you weren't ready to come back? You might have walked away. Is there someone that want to come back? If that's you, you stand. Stand up on your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We're getting ready to say a prayer. We call this the sinner's prayer. This is a prayer that if you say it with a sincere heart, according to Romans 10:9, you shall be saved. Amen. Is there anyone else? God bless your heart. God bless you. Amen. God bless you. So as we say this prayer, even if you're still in your seat, God bless you. God bless you. Even if you're still in your seat, all you have to do is repeat the prayer and it'll be up to you too. Let's pray. Dear God, forgive me of all my sins. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I believe Jesus died for my sin. I want him to be my Lord and my Savior. Holy Spirit, fill me with your power. Lead me, guide me, order my steps. Satan, I rebuke you. From this day forward, I serve you no more. I put you under my feet in the Jesus' name.